गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सिविक्स चैप्टर 9 पब्लिक फैसिलिटीज। ओके, यू नो चिल्ड्रन, पब्लिक फैसिलिटीज रिलेट टू आवर बेसिक नीड्स, इज़न्ट इट? यस। सो पब्लिक फैसिलिटीज रिलेट टू आवर बेसिक नीड्स सच एज वाटर, हेल्थ, एजुकेशन, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, ट्रांसपोर्ट एक्सेट्रा, राइट? दीज आर द बेसिक नीड्स for us, right? So public facilities generally relate to our basic needs such as water, health, education, then transport, electricity, etc., isn't it? So the government is expected to play a major role in providing public facilities to all. Yes, because always we used to tell the government should provide free health, free education, free transport, right? So the government is expected to play a major role in providing public facilities to all. Okay, first, water is the basic need of the people. Yes, do you agree? Yes, of course we should agree, because water is the basic need of the people, right? So it is essential for life and for good health, isn't it? Yes. So safe drinking water can prevent several waterborne diseases such as diarrhea, dysentery, cholera, etc., isn't it? Yes, that's why, especially if you see during the rainy season, government used to announce people should be aware of drinking water, because people should boil the water, then only they should take, otherwise the waterborne diseases will spread. Okay, so but unfortunately India has the largest number of cases of these waterborne diseases such as diarrhea, dysentery, cholera, etc. So safe drinking water can prevent several waterborne diseases such as diarrhea, dysentery, cholera, etc. Okay, now we are going to see water and the people of Chennai. It means for case study in Chennai, how the people get water, especially in a posh area, how the people used to get, as well as in slum area, how people will get their basic needs, okay, especially water and all. So here, water and the people of Chennai, if we take Mr. Ram Gopal lives in Annanagar, Chennai. This area looks lush and green with lawns maintained by a generous spring of watering. Eppadi irundhadu nalla lawn which big bungalows, like they get water generously, nalla neriyave avangalukku sufficient water kadachathu. Likewise, in an apartment where Mr. Subramaniam lives, water supply is inadequate. Actually, Mr. Subramaniam used to spend rupees 500 to 600 per month on buying water from the tankers. Okay, another case history says Mr. Shiva lives on rent on the first floor of a house in Madipakam and gets water once in 4 days. So shortage of water is one of the main reason why Shiva can't bring his family to Chennai, because for drinking Shiva buys bottled water. So how it is possible to maintain his family so that he is living alone, their family is in his native. Okay, next we are going to see about another case history. Batma works as a domestic help in Saidapet and lives in nearby slum area. La avanga oru domestic help pandranga, veet vela pandravanga. She pays a rent of rupees 650 for the hut mint, which has neither a bathroom nor a tap connection. See, their how she is paying. without bathroom facilities and tap connection, she is paying ₹650 for her house rent. Okay. For 30 such hutments, there is a common tap at one's corner in which water comes from a borewell for 20 minutes twice daily. See here, a family gets to fill a maximum of 3 buckets within this time. So here the same water is used for washing and drinking. In summer, the flow become a trickle. What happened? So that only family gets water, one at the cost of another. People have to wait long hours for water tankers. You imagine about the water scarcity, how the people are suffering for getting water and all. Okay, so we have to be very careful to use water. We should save water, isn't it? Yes. You know, children, generally borewell water is brackish. So the residents use it in their toilets and for washing only. For other uses, water is purchased from tankers. Right, brackish means salty water. Okay. Now, we are going to see about water as part of the fundamental right to life. Okay. Yes, already I have told you how water is essential for our life and for our good health, isn't it? Yes. See, children, safe drinking water can prevent many water-related diseases. Yes, waterborne diseases. So, India has one of the largest number of cases of diseases such as diarrhea, dysentery, cholera. Over 1,600 Indians, most of them children below the age of 5, reportedly died every day because of water-related diseases. See the data. Below the age of 5, die every day because of water-related diseases. So these deaths can be prevented if people have access to safe drinking water, isn't it? So in order to avoid this kind of diseases like water-related diseases, what should we do? We should drink good drinking water, safe drinking water, right? You know, children, the Constitution of India recognizes the right to water as being a part of the right to life under Article 21. So, which article guarantees right to life, right to water as being a part of the right to life? Article 21. So, in this Article 21, in the Indian Constitution, guarantees the right to water as being a part of the right to life. Okay, so in which article provides this provision, right to life? Article 21. Okay, this means that it is the right of every person, whether rich or poor, to have sufficient amounts of water to fulfill their needs. Okay, at a price that they can afford. So, in other words, there should be universal access to water. Yes. See, children, there have been several court cases in which both the high courts and the Supreme Court have held that the right to safe drinking water is a fundamental right. Actually, more recently, in 2007, the Andhra Pradesh High Court restated this while hearing a case based on a letter written by a villager of Mahboobnagar district on the contamination of drinking water. So the villagers' complaint was that a textile company was discharging poisonous chemicals into a stream near his village. So contaminating groundwater, it contaminates the groundwater which was the source for irrigation and drinking water. So the judges directed the Mahboobnagar district collector to supply 25 liters of water to each person in the village. See, ஒரு கேஸ் நடந்தது அதில் ஆந்திர பிரதேஷில் ஹைகோர்ட்டில் சொல்லியிருக்காங்க பிகாஸ் அங்கே இருக்கிற ஒரு டெக்ஸ்டைல் கம்பெனியால் அவங்களுடைய இரிகேஷன் அண்ட் ட்ரிங்கிங் வாட்டர் ப்ரொவைட் பண்ணுற ஒரு ஸ்ட்ரீமில் இந்த மாதிரி ஆல் கண்டாமினேட்டட் டிச்சார்ஜிங் எல்லாம் மிக்ஸ் ஆகிறதுனால பாய்சனஸ் கெமிக்கல்ஸ் எல்லாம் மிக்ஸ் ஆகிறதுனால தே ஆர் நாட் ஏபிள் டு ட்ரிங்க், தே ஆர் நாட் ஏபிள் டு யூஸ் த வாட்டர். ஸோ தே ஃபைல் த கேஸ் அகேன்ஸ்ட் த டெக்ஸ்டைல் கம்பெனி அண்ட் கோர்ட் டைரக்டட் த டிஸ்ட்ரிக்ட் கலெக்டர் மஹபூப் நகர் டிஸ்ட்ரிக்ட் கலெக்டர் டு சப்ளை ஹவு மெனி லிட்டர்ஸ், 25 லிட்டர்ஸ் ஆஃப் வாட்டர் டு ஈச் பர்சன் இன் த வில்லேஜ். ஓகே, now we are going to see about the public facilities. See children, already I have told you, like water, there are other essential facilities that need to be provided for everyone. Yes, in fact last year you have read about two other important facilities, healthcare and sanitation, isn't it? In your 7th standard you have studied about healthcare and sanitation. Similarly, there are things like electricity, public transport, schools and colleges that are also necessary. These are known as public facilities. Okay. So, what are known as public facilities? Facilities like water, electricity, public transport, schools and colleges, healthcare and sanitation are known as public facilities. Okay. Now we are going to see about the important characteristic of a public facility. Okay, see children, what is the important characteristic of a public facility? Once if it is provided, its benefits can be shared by many people. Okay, so don't forget, the important characteristic of a public facility is, once this facility is provided, its benefits can be shared by many people. That is the very, very important characteristic of a public facility. Okay, so already we have known about the public facilities. What are they? Facilities like water, electricity, public transport, schools and colleges, healthcare and sanitation are known as public facilities, isn't it? Yes. So, what is the important characteristic of a public facility? Once it is provided, its benefits, these public facilities benefits can be shared by many people. Okay, for example, if the government starts a school in a village, many children will be admitted to the school, right? So many children will get education. Like if they start a college, then many students will get college education, right? So that once it is provided, these benefits will be shared by many people. Okay, that is the important characteristic of a public facility. Got it? Now we are going to see about the government's role in providing public facilities to the people. Okay, see children, the public facilities are so important, we know very well, right? In fact, the Indian Constitution guarantees the right to education for all children between the ages of 6 to 14 years. So, the Indian Constitution guarantees the right to education for all children between the ages of 6 to 14 years. Okay. So, the government should provide education to the children, as well as they should start many schools to provide education, isn't it? So, okay, however the facilities are provided, but who will take this responsibility? Of course the government, right? So the government take this responsibility of providing these public facilities to the people, right? So one of the most important functions of the government is to ensure that these public facilities are made available to everyone. See, once if they implemented any colleges or any schemes for well-being of people, they should follow that, they ensure that these public facilities are made available to everyone. everyone, all the people are getting these facilities or not. Like that, the government should follow. Okay. So now let's try and understand why the government must bear this responsibility. Yes, we will see. See, if we take private transport, compare the tickets rate. However, it will be higher than our government transport, public transport. Why? Because the private companies operate for profit in the market, right? Their motive is to get benefit, to get profit from their business. But in government sector, they won't think like that. Their duty, their basic responsibility is to ensure that the people of state get public facilities. Okay, so that the government is taking responsibility. And you know, children, for the drainage cleaning and running an anti-malaria campaign, the malaria kidran and the anti-malaria campaign, a private company will probably not be interested in undertaking such work. Yes, they won't get profit from this anti-malaria campaign. Malaria ku edrana ipo the tadupu mugamgal idellam potanga na adula private sector won't get benefit, so that they won't be interested to conduct all those campaigns, right? But for other public facilities such as schools and hospitals, private companies, they will be interested. Yes, of course, because they are ready to open many private schools, hospitals, private companies. Why? Because they will get profit from this. So that what are the sectors are given profits to the people, to the private sector, they will be ready to start this kind of hospitals, schools, colleges, etc. But the drains clean and anti-malaria campaign and all won't be taken by the private companies, okay, because they won't get benefit from that. So that, but on the other hand, the government needs to play an active role in providing adequate access to proper health facilities for the entire population. Yes, see, this includes the eradication of preventable diseases like polio. Yes, ipo polio illada nada India vandirukku appadina polio sottu mugam pathinga yearly twice the government will conduct the campaign. Okay, so like indha madri cholera eradicate pandra, cholera illada country a maathanum, like what else, polio illada country a maathanum abingiradhula government odiye full responsibility, and they will take more initiative to in order to prevent these diseases like polio and all. Okay, see children, at the same time you will have seen private companies supplying water through tankers or supplying drinking water in sealed bottles. Yes, Aquafin, like for example Aquafin and other companies are issuing that sealed bottles, right? And water gallons also available. These and all private companies are doing, right? In such cases, private companies provide public facilities, but at a price that only some people can afford. Hence, this facility is not available to all at an affordable rate. So, if we go by the rule that people will get as much as they can pay for, then many people who cannot afford to pay for such facilities, so they will be deprived of the opportunity to live a decent life. Yes, because they are not able to afford this cost and all, so they will be deprived. Adla irunda avanga odukapadranga and of the opportunity to live decent life. Okay, so that all the people can't afford to buy the sealed bottles and water gallons and all, right? So the prices is not affordable by everybody. Okay, but generally public facilities relate to people's basic needs. Yes, already we have seen it, right? Any modern society requires that these facilities are provided so that people's basic needs are met. Yes, of course. Okay, children, government is providing public facilities for the people, right? So where does the government get money for public facilities? How they are getting? See, every year you must have heard the government budget being presented in the parliament, right? Budget thakal seyyapadudhu every year popping. This is an account of the expenses the government has made on its programs in the past year and how much it plans to spend in the coming year. லாஸ்ட் இயர் அவங்க ஹெல்த் கேர்க்கு எவ்வளோ பண்ணியிருக்காங்க, எவ்வளோ ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்ணியிருக்காங்க, இந்த வருஷம் இன்னும் எவ்வளோ இன்க்ளூட் பண்ணியிருக்காங்க, இதெல்லாம் வந்து அந்த பட்ஜெட்லேயே தான் நமக்கு தெரிய வரும். ஸோ இந்த பட்ஜெட் த கவர்மெண்ட் ஆல்சோ அனௌன்சஸ் த வேரியஸ் வேஸ் இன் விச் இட் பிளான்ஸ் டு மீட் தீஸ் எக்ஸ்பென்சஸ். பட்ஜெட்டுடைய பேசிக்கான இன்கம் எவ்வளோ, எக்ஸ்பெண்டிச்சர் எவ்வளோ, how to tackle all those extra expenses, in which way we can levy the duties, right? Endha mariyana taxes levy pannalangiradella avanga plan panni dhaan the budget daakil pannuvaanga. So the main source of revenue for the government is the taxes collected from the people, right? And the government is empowered to collect these taxes and use them for such programs. பீப்புள்கிட்ட இருந்தால் நம்மளோட மக்களுடைய வரிப்பணத்தில் தான் கவர்மெண்ட் ரன் பண்ணுறாங்க, ரைட்? ஸோ ஃபார் இன்ஸ்டன்ஸ், டு சப்ளை வாட்டர் த கவர்மெண்ட் ஹேஸ் டு இன்கர் காஸ்ட் இன் பம்பிங் வாட்டர், கேரிங் இட் ஓவர் லாங் டிஸ்டன்சஸ், லேயிங் டவுன் பைப்ஸ் ஃபார் டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூஷன், தென் ட்ரீட்டிங் த வாட்டர் ஃபார் இம்ப்யூரிட்டிஸ் அண்ட் ஃபைனலி collecting and treating waste water, right? So avangalukku enna enna responsibility irukku, ellathukkum pipelines podanum, irrigation facilities create panni kudukanum, long distance ku eppadi pipeline, through pipeline how they are taking water from river to that villages. So all those expenses they have to face, so that the government will plan according to that, according to the needs they will plan and execute. Okay, so especially in the, if you see sometimes in the roadways, if you see that pipeline leakages will be occur and the water will be wasted, right? So that it should not be like that. The government should take care of the distribution and treating the water for impurities and finally collecting and treating waste water. Okay, so the government meets these expenses partly from the various taxes that it collects from the people, right? So what taxes, like property tax, income tax, exercise tax, customs duty, sales tax, right? So many taxes have been levied by the government, and they will collect the taxes from the people, and they will use the taxes to provide these public facilities. Okay, you know children, buses are the most important forms of public transport over short distances. Yes, yes, of course, it is the main link to the workplace for majority of the working people. Yes, because many people will use government buses, right, to reach their working place, right? Especially with the rapid urbanization, the public bus system even in the major cities has not been able to keep up with the demand. Yes, see, the nagarmaya model abdingad adhigamanadanal the public bus system in the major cities has not been able to keep with the demand. Yes, the morning session pathina working class people office ella paakrappa morning evlo rush a irukku usually bus la, right? So it's not compete the demand. So that as an alternative, the government has planned ambitious metro rail projects for Delhi and other metropolitan cities. So அதனால தான் சென்னை டெல்லி அப்படின்ற அந்த மெட்ரோபாலிட்டன் சிட்டிஸ்லேயெல்லாம் மெட்ரோ ரயில் சிஸ்டத்தை அவங்க இன்ட்ரடியூஸ் பண்ணாங்க. பிகாஸ் இட்ஸ் நாட் என் ஆஃப் டு மீட் தேர் டிமாண்ட்ஸ். பஸ் த பப்ளிக் பஸ் ட்ரான்ஸ்போர்ட் இஸ் நாட் என் ஆஃப் ஸோ தேட் த மெட்ரோ ரயில் ப்ராஜெக்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் டெல்லி அண்ட் அதர் மெட்ரோபாலிட்டன் சிட்டிஸ் வேர் இன்ட்ரடியூஸ்ட். இன்ஃபேக்ட் ருபீஸ் 11,000 crore was spent from the government budget for the construction of the first segment of the metro rail in Delhi, okay, using the latest technology. You know children, first place first metro rail system has planned and introduced in Delhi. After that in second was in Hyderabad. In fact, in Chennai, metro is the third metro system in India. Okay, so in order to provide transports in public transports to the people, the government has introduced many metro rails in the various metropolitan cities like Delhi, Hyderabad, Mumbai, Calcutta and Chennai, etc. Okay. Now we are going to see about water supply to Chennai. Is it available to all? Yes, we'll see. See children, public facilities should be made available to all by the government. But in reality, we see that there is a great shortage of such facilities, isn't it? Yes, do you agree? Yes. See, in Chennai, water supply is marked by shortages. Yes, see, municipal corporation's water supply meets only about the half the needs of the people of the city and an average, right? See, the burden of shortfalls in water supply falls mostly on the poor. So yeah, shortage of municipal water is often taken as a sign of failure of the government. Yes. See, இமீடியட்டாக என்ன பண்ணுறாங்க, பீப்புள்லாம் அஜிடேட் பண்ணுவாங்க. அஃப்கோர்ஸ் வி ஆர் நாட் கெட்டிங் முன்சிபல் வாட்டர் வீக்லி ஒன்ஸ், ஒன்லி வி ஆர் கெட்டிங் வித் இன் 10 days ஒன்ஸ் வி ஆர் கெட்டிங் லைக் தட். ஸோ தேட் யா ஷார்ட்டேஜ் ஆஃப் முன்சிபல் வாட்டர் இஸ் ஆஃபன் டேக்கன் அஸ் அ சைன் ஆஃப் ஃபெயிலியர் ஆஃப் த கவர்மெண்ட், இசன்ட் இட்? எஸ். அண்ட் ஆல்சோ யூ நோ த ஏரியாஸ் விச் கெட் வாட்டர் மோர் ரெகுலர்லி தென் அதர்ஸ் are close to the storage points, whereas colonies further away receive less water. எங்கே அந்த ஸ்டோரேஜ் வாட்டர் டேங்க்குக்கு பக்கத்தில் இருக்கிற அந்த ஏரியாஸ் எல்லாம் ரெகுலர் வாட்டர் சப்ளை கிடைக்கும், பட் ரொம்ப டிஸ்டன்ஸில் இருக்கிற ஏரியாஸ் எல்லாம் காலனிஸ் எல்லாம் தே வில் கெட் லெஸ் வாட்டர். ஓகே, ஸோ த மிடில் கிளாஸ் வென் ஃபேஸ்ட் வித் வாட்டர் ஷார்ட்டேஜஸ் ஆர் ஏபிள் டு கோப் த்ரூ எ வெரைட்டி ஆஃப் ப்ரைவேட் மீன்ஸ் சச் அஸ் டிக்கிங் போர்வெல்ஸ், பையிங் வாட்டர் ஃப்ரம் டேங்கர்ஸ் அண்ட் யூஸிங் பாட்டில்ட் வாட்டர்ஸ் ஃபார் ட்ரிங்கிங். பட் இந்த புவர் கிளாஸ் பீப்புள் வில் சஃபர் அ லாட். ஓகே, ஸோ அப்பார்ட் ஃப்ரம் த அவைலபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் வாட்டர், அக்சஸ் டு சேஃப் ட்ரிங்கிங் வாட்டர் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அவைலபிள் டு சம். And this depends on what one can afford. Yes, for example, நம்ம சேஃப்டி ட்ரிங்கிங் வாட்டருக்கு என்ன பண்ணுறோம், ஒவ்வொரு கேன் அஃபர்ட் வீல் பை அ வாட்டர் கேலன், ரைட்? ஆல் எவ்ரி ஒன் கேன் நாட் அஃபோர்ட் டு கெட் சேஃப் ட்ரிங்கிங் வாட்டர், ரைட்? ஸோ ஒன்ஸ் அகெய்ன் த வெல்த்தி ஹாவ் மோர் சாய்ஸஸ் அண்ட் தே யூஸ் டு கெட் தட் சீல்டு வாட்டர் பாட்டில்ஸ் and water purifiers, right? Whereas the poor are again left out. So in reality, it seems that it is only people with money who have the right to water, a far cry from the goal of universal access to sufficient and safe water. Yes. See children, if you see in rural areas, water is needed both for human use and for use by the cattle, isn't it? Yes. So the sources of water are wells hand pumps, ponds, and sometimes overhead tanks, right? So much of these are privately owned. Compared to the urban areas, there is an even greater shortage of public water supply in rural areas. Yes, simply we can say, compared than urban areas, nama cities avida, there is an even greater shortage of public water supply in rural areas. கிராமப்புறங்கள்லையும் அதே அளவுக்கான வாட்டர் ஷார்ட்டேஜ் இருக்க தான் செய்யுது, ரைட்? யூ நோ சில்ட்ரன், த ஷார்ட்டேஜ் ஆஃப் வாட்டர் ஹேஸ் ஓப்பன்ட் அப் ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டிஸ் ஃபார் ப்ரைவேட் கம்பெனிஸ் இன் அ பிக் வே. டு யூ அக்ரி? எஸ், யூ கேன் சி மெனி ப்ரைவேட் டேங்கர்ஸ் ஹூ சப்ளை வாட்டர் டு த பீப்புள், ரைட்? In fact, many private companies are providing water to cities by buying it from places around the city. In Chennai, water is taken from nearby towns like Mamandur, Palur, Karangili, and from villages to the north of the city using a fleet of over 13,000 water tankers. Okay. Here, every month the water dealers pay farmers an advance for the rights to exploit water sources on their land. Yes, so this is water taken away not just from agriculture but also from the drinking water supplies of the villages. So groundwater levels have dropped drastically in all these towns and villages as a result. Okay. See children, the situation in Chennai is not unique. In fact, this similar scenario of shortages and acute crisis during the summer month is common to other cities of India. Okay, so the shortage in municipal water is increasingly being filled by an expansion of private companies who are selling water for profit. So, common are the great inequalities in water use. So, the supply of water per person in an urban area in India should be about 135 liters per day, nearly about 7 buckets, a standard set by the Urban Water Commission. Whereas, people in slums have to make do with less than 20 liters a day per person, nearly 1 bucket. So, people living in luxury hotels may consume as much as 1,600 liters, nearly 80 buckets of water per day. Okay, this is the data that are given by Urban Water Commission. Okay. You know children, some people are of the opinion that private companies should be allowed to take over that task of water supply. Why the people are telling like this? Because some people say that since the government is unable to supply the amount of water that is needed and many of the municipal water departments are running at a loss, that they should allow private companies to take over the task of water supply. According to them, private companies can perform better. So this is the opinion of some people. Okay. You know children, throughout the world, water supply is a function of the government. Yes, of course, there are, but there are very few instances of private water supply. There are areas in the world where public water supply has achieved universal access. Porto Alegre is a city in Brazil. Though there are many poor people in this city, you know the remarkable is it has a far lower number of infant deaths as compared to most other cities of the world. So the city's water department has achieved universal access to safe water, and this is the main reason behind the lower number of infant deaths. So what is the name of the city? Porto Alegre. It is in Brazil. Okay. So the average price of water is kept low and the poor are charged half the basic rate. So whatever profit the department makes is used to improve the water supply. So the working of the water department is transparent and people can have a direct say in deciding which projects the department should take up. ஸோ ரொம்ப வெளிப்படையான நிர்வாகமாக இருந்ததுனால மக்களால் அதை தெரிஞ்சுக்க முடிஞ்சுது. த்ரூ எ ப்ராசஸ் ஆஃப் பப்ளிக் மீட்டிங் பீப்புள் ஹியர் வாட் த மேனேஜர்ஸ் ஹாவ் டு சே அண்ட் ஆல்சோ வோட் ஆன் தேர் ப்ரையாரிட்டிஸ். ஸோ இந்த மாதிரி பிரேசிலில் ஒரு பேசிக் ஒரு வில்லேஜில் சேஃப் ட்ரிங்கிங் வாட்டர் ப்ரொவைட் பண்ணுறதுனால ரொம்ப லோயர் நம்பர் ஆஃப் இன்ஃபேண்ட் டெத்ஸாக இருக்குது பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் த யூனிவர்சல் ஆக்சஸ் ஆஃப் சேஃப் ட்ரிங்கிங் வாட்டர். ஓகே, பட் அட் த சேம் டைம் இன் ஃபியூ கேசஸ் வேர் த ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி ஃபார் வாட்டர் சப்ளை வாஸ் ஹேண்டட் ஓவர் டு ப்ரைவேட் கம்பெனிஸ் தேர் வாஸ் த ஸ்டீப் ரைஸ் இன் த ப்ரைஸ் ஆஃப் வாட்டர் மேக்கிங் இட் அன்அஃபோர்டபுள் ஃபார் மெனி. ஸோ தேட் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலி பீப்புள் அஜிட்டேட்டட், பீப்புள் அகேன்ஸ்ட் தட் பாலிசிஸ். ஸோ சிட்டிஸ் சா ஹியூஜ் ப்ரோட்டெஸ்ட் அண்ட் இன்ஃபேக்ட் ரைட்ஸ் பிரேக்கிங் அவுட் இன் பிளேசஸ் லைக் போல்வியா, forcing the government to take back the service from private hands. So this also happened. But if you see in India, there are cases of success in government water departments, though these are few in number and limited to certain areas of their work. Actually, the water supply department in Mumbai raises enough money through water charges to cover its expenses on supplying water. In Hyderabad, a recent report shows that the department has increased coverage and improved performance in revenue collection. In fact, in Chennai, the department has taken several measures for harvesting rainwater to increase the level of groundwater. Yes, we have seen our government has insisted to build rainwater harvesting pits and all, right? Because it uses to increase the groundwater level, right? And it has also used the services of private companies for transporting and distributing water. But the government water supply department decides the rate for water tankers and gives them permission to operate. So hence they are called on contract. Yes, on contract based, the government has appointed private water tankers to supply waters wherever it needs. Okay. You know, children, Mumbai's suburban railway is well-functioning public transport system. சுபர்பன் ரயில்வேஸ் புறநகர் ரயில்வேன்னு சொல்லுவோம், சென்னை புறநகர் ரயில் நிலையம்லாம் கேள்விப்பட்டிருப்பீங்க. ஸோ சிட்டியை விட்டு அவுட்டர்லேருந்து நமக்கு கனெக்ட் ஆகிறது. மும்பை சுபர்பன் ரயில்வே இஸ் வெல் ஃபங்க்ஷனிங் பப்ளிக் ட்ரான்ஸ்போர்ட் சிஸ்டம். ஆக்சுவலி இட் இஸ் த டென்சஸ்ட் ரூட் இன் த வேர்ல்டு, அட்டெண்டிங் டு 65 lakh பேசஞ்சர்ஸ் டெய்லி. அவுட்டர்லேருந்து சிட்டிக்கு டெய்லி ஒர்க்குக்கு வந்துட்டு போனவங்களுடையது நியர்லி 65 lakh பேசஞ்சர்ஸ். ஓகே, அண்ட் எக்ஸ்டெண்டிங் ஓவர் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் 300 kilometers, தீஸ் லோக்கல் ட்ரெயின்ஸ் அலோ பீப்புள் லிவிங் ஃபார் அவே ஃப்ரம் மும்பை டு ஃபைண்ட் ஒர்க் இன் த சிட்டி. ஸோ நோட் தட் த ஹை காஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஹவுசிங் இன் சிட்டிஸ் மேக்ஸ் இட் இம்பாசிபிள் ஃபார் அன் ஆவரேஜ் ஒர்க்கர் டு லிவ் இன் த சிட்டி. ஸோ தட் தே யூஸ் டு ப்ரிஃபர் லிவ் இன் அவுட்டர் ஆஃப் த அவுட்ஸ்கர்ட் ஆஃப் த சிட்டி. ஸோ தட் தே வில் யூஸ் திஸ் மெட்ரோ, தட் சுபர்பன் ரயில்வே அண்ட் கம் டு த சிட்டி ஃபார் தேர் ஒர்க். இஸ்ன்ட் இட்? எஸ். See children, besides safe drinking water, sanitation is a must in prevention of waterborne diseases. Yes, however, the sanitation coverage in India is even lower than that of water. Actually, official figures for 2001 show that 68% of the households in India have access to drinking water and about 36% have access to sanitation. It means toilet facilities within the premises of their residence. Now, once again, it is the poor both in the rural and urban areas who lack access to sanitation. So, Sulabh ஆக்சுவலி எ நான் கவர்மெண்ட் ஆர்கனைசேஷன், அதாவது என்ஜிஓஸ்ன்னு சொல்லுவோம்ல அதுதான். நான் கவர்மெண்ட் ஆர்கனைசேஷன் ஹேஸ் பீன் ஒர்க்கிங் ஃபார் 3 decades டு அட்ரஸ் த ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் ஆஃப் சானிடேஷன் ஃபேஸிங் லோ காஸ்ட் லோ இன்கம் பீப்புள் இன் இண்டியா. எஸ் ஈவன் டுடே இஃப் யூ சி த ரிமோட் ஏரியாஸ், தேர் வோன்ட் பி சானிடேஷன், பீப்புள் மேக்ஸிமம் பீப்புள் வோன்ட் ஹாவ் டாய்லெட்ஸ் ஃபெசிலிட்டிஸ் இன் தேர் ஹவுஸ் இன் தேர் ஹவுசஸ். ஸோ தேட் இட் ஹேஸ் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டட் மோர் தேன் 7,500 பப்ளிக் டாய்லெட் பிளாக்ஸ் அண்ட் 1.2 million ப்ரைவேட் டாய்லெட்ஸ், கிவிங் அக்சஸ் டு சானிடேஷன் டு 10 million பீப்புள். திஸ் ஒர்க் வாஸ் டன் பை ஹூம்? சுலாப், a non-government organization. So the majority of the users of Sulabh facilities are from the poor working class, and Sulabh as a non-government organization enters into contracts with municipalities or other local authorities to construct toilet blocks with government funds. So in the Sulabh enna pandranga, government kuda டையப் வச்சுட்டு எங்கெங்கெல்லாம் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் பண்ணணுமோ டால் பிளாக்ஸ் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ட் பண்ணுற ஒர்க்லேயும் அவங்க இன்வால்வ் ஆகுறாங்க. ஸோ சுலாப் என்டர்ஸ் இன் டு கான்ட்ராக்ட்ஸ் வித் முனிசிபாலிட்டிஸ் ஆர் அதர் லோக்கல் அத்தாரிட்டிஸ் டு கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ட் டாய்லெட் பிளாக்ஸ் வித் கவர்மெண்ட் ஃபண்ட்ஸ். இன்ஃபேக்ட் லோக்கல் அத்தாரிட்டிஸ் ப்ரொவைட் லேண்ட் அண்ட் ஃபண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் செட்டிங் அப் த சர்வீசஸ், வேரஸ் மெயின்டெனன்ஸ் காஸ்ட் ஆர் சம்டைம்ஸ் financed through user charge. For example, ₹1 is charged for use of the latrines in the cities. You know children, the Census of India 2001 puts rural household electrification at 44%, leaving around 78 million households still in the dark. அதாவது electricity facilities இல்லாத 78 million households still in the dark. Okay, at last we have come to the end of this chapter. So children, public facilities relate to our basic needs, right? And the Indian constitution recognized the right to water, health, education, etc. as being a part of the right to life. In which article guarantees right to life? Of course, Article 21, isn't it? Yes, don't forget that. And also, the right to water, health, education, etc. as being a part of the right to life. Okay. So, the major role of the government is to ensure adequate public facilities for everyone. Got it? So public facilities relate to people's basic needs, isn't it? So every citizen of the country has a right to these facilities, which should be provided to them in an equitable manner. Okay, so children, I hope you all understood this chapter clearly. Thank you.